going massive. Scope Service follows the story of an 8-year-old schoolgirl who gets kidnapped and is forced to become a beggar in the streets of Manila. So first of all, I'd like to ask you about the origin of your film and about the inspiration you had while creating such a touching story.
Good morning. For me, I love doing those kinds of films. I love reality films, especially the scenes in the streets, and that inspires me to produce this. Actually, I am one of the producers of this particular film, and I see them every day when I go to work, from home to work, every day. That inspired me to produce this and join the Cinema Lion Independent Film Festival in the Philippines. That's the first festival that we joined. The story originated in a photo of an 8-year-old girl holding a big rock in front of a car. On high, on drugs, on we call it in the Philippines, it's rugby, but it's a solvent. They use that for them to not to get hungry, to have the courage to you know to fight for having monies outside in the street.
Actually, the film had the scene of a girl throwing a rock at the car, so now I understand this. Because this film shows such disturbing images of young kids, as far as I understand, you have been working with child actors, not real kids from the street. So how was it, this experience of working with child actors, but with such different scenes?
It's a difficult film. They auditioned for the role. A conference audition, and we had an immersion with, we are all inside the van on the first 3 days of before we shoot. Then it's the time they see children on the streets, and that's some kind of the immersion we had before we shoot, and some kind of a workshop also for them, because they are first time actors. It's really hard for them at the start for to speak in some bad languages, expressions, especially the little ones, the three young kids. At first, they don't want to use bad words, but I told them that they are actors. They need to do that, and that was just for the film. And then they followed.
What was the reception of film in the Philippines? Did you have a release, or so how did the Philippine audiences react to the film?
First, the reaction was really shocking, and we don't have yet the commercial release of this movie. Maybe after this festival, and we're planning to show this to the Senate for them to realize, or to for us to show them the real problem this is in Manila and in Quezon City, especially in Manila. Yeah. The film, the actress won, that my three main actors won in the Cinema Lion, the best actress, the supporting, and the best child actor. And hopefully, during the mainstream release, the main release of this film, they will like it, and they will realize the real problem in my country.
The film was made kind of from a child's point of view. So I'm from Russia, and in Russia we have such films that are usually kind of family films or fairy tale films. So did you use this intentionally? Why did you decide to use such point of view in Secret Heavens?
Well, number one is I want them to see children, to see children's innocence. So that's very important. Clean mind, clean spirit, clean heart. So that's why I use kids, especially my 8-year-old girl. And the story is 24 hours, just 24 hours upon the kidnapping. And I want them, I want the audience to follow their journey, their individual stories and their struggle during the 24 hours. And I am very fond of doing short film.
One of my other impressions was that it was interesting to follow the adult characters of the story because they were not portrayed as purely evil entities, but in fact as people who got in difficult social situations themselves, and living for them is the only way to lead their lives as they could. So what feeling do you have about this?
I do lots of symbolism in the movie. I use school surface per se. The vehicle symbolizes my country. The kid symbolizes the people, us. And the adult actor symbolizes the politicians. Because there's too much politicking in the Philippines. That's why we have those kinds of situations. Really, that is true.
So this film is kind of a statement, or does it feel more like a dramatic expression? Because it definitely has some dramatic direction. So for you, it's it goes into this statement area, right?
It is a statement, actually, for us to realize the importance of children, the safetyness. It's not safe for our children to just go around outside because, you know, there's a lot of, especially in my country, there's a lot of syndicates, bad elements, you know, drugs, you know, so better be safe for them.
So can we call it a call for actions, and what actions should
take? That's why I produced this. I want particularly the President and the Senate to actually see this kind of movie, to see this movie, for them to realize and to give them projects or solutions to this problem. This one, but in other cases, other shocking cases also. Yes.
I think that's it. So it was really nice talking to you.